Hello everyone. In this tutorial, we are going to understand the typical architecture or a typical structure of the numerical relay. So, what is the typical structure of numerical relay? This is our structure of our relay. So, first we have here the power system, which having a voltage and also current that is flowing in the power system. And here is the whole numerical relay. Here is our numerical relay. But here is the CPU, which is the central processing unit of the numerical relay. So what are these components and what is the function of each component in this structure? So first we have here the transducers. So the high voltage and high current of the power system are stepped down by using transducers. These transducers like CT, current transformer, or voltage transformers. So first, the high voltage and the high current are stepped down by using these transducers. Then, we have here two main categories of the numerical relay. First category is called the analog input subsystem, or the analog input system, which is actually a signal conditioner. Then we have the analog interface with the CPU. All of these categories are called data acquisition system. So first, let's understand the signal conditioner. We have here an analog input isolation. This analog input isolation is used to isolate between the power circuit and the control circuit of the relay. It's used to isolate between the power circuit of our power system and also the control circuit, which is the numerical relay. This isolation can be made by auxiliary isolation devices or isolation transformer. Then we have the I to V converter, current to voltage converter. For the numerical relay, it only deals with voltage signals. So, I to V converter is used to convert the current from the current transformer into a voltage signal proportional to the current. So, any signal except that the voltage signal should be converted into a voltage signal. This voltage signal is proportional to the main signal. For example, if we have here a current from a current transformer, this current should be converted first to a voltage. This voltage is a representation, or this voltage is proportional to the current of the current transformer. If we have here a frequency of the power system, this frequency should be converted into a voltage. This voltage is proportional to the frequency of the power system, because the numerical relay and the central processing unit deals only with the voltage signals. So I to V converter is used to convert any signal except that voltage signal into a voltage signal. So this is the main function of I to V converter. Then we have the low pass filter, or it's also called anti-aliasing filter. This filter is used to eliminate the noisy signal, which is the high frequency signals that occur in the our main signal. So it's used to eliminate the noisy signal in the system due to corona or induction effect from a nearby high voltage line. This filter is used to pass the low frequency signals, such as our power signal, which has a frequency 50 or 60 hertz, and eliminates the high frequency signals, such as the noisy signal that can be introduced because corona or induction effect from the nearby high voltage line. So this is the main function of the low pass filter. So here, at this point, we got the analog isolated signal without any noisy. This analog signal should be converted into digital signal or digital data using analog to digital converter. So here we have the analog to digital converter to convert the analog signal into a digital signal. But before the analog to digital converter, we have two components. The first component is called sample and hold circuit. What is the meaning of sample and hold circuit? And what is the function of sample and hold circuit? So for the analog to digital converter to operate, its operation depends on the sampling theorem. What is the meaning of sampling theorem? If we have here our analog signal, let's say that we have analog voltage signal. As we see, this signal is continuous analog signal with time. This signal, as we see. Now we need to convert this analog signal to a digital signal or digital data. So we make sampling, as we see. At this point, we take a sampling for the analog voltage. After this point, after a certain time, which is very, very, very small, and this time is called sampling time. So this time is called the sampling interval time, which has a value t. So at this moment, we will take a sample for the analog signal. After this moment, we will hold an sampling time t, then we will take a sample at this time. So we need to make a sample and then to make a hold. So we use a sample and hold circuit for this purpose. Sample and hold circuit will make a sample and then hold for a very, very, very small time. This time in range of milli or microseconds, according to the sampling frequency. Then we will make another sample. Then we will make another sample and so on. So sample and hold circuit is used to make samples to convert the analog signals into a digital signal, and also to make a hold between the two successive samples. So this is the main function of sample and hold circuit. Then we have the analog multiplexer before the analog to digital converter. What is the meaning of analog multiplexer? For multiple analog signals needed to be converted into digital data, a multiplexer is used for selecting the required analog input for digital conversion. For example, if we have four signals to be converted into digital signal, first signal is voltage signal, the second signal is current signal, the third signal is temperature signal, and the fourth signal is frequency signal. So this is actually a multiplexer. It has several inputs, but it has one output. Let's see, the first input is a voltage signal, second input is the current, and third is the temperature, and the fourth signal is the frequency. So the multiplexer is used to select the required analog input for digital converter. For example, now we need to convert the voltage signal into digital, so the output here will be a voltage. After a certain time, we need to convert the current into digital signal, so the output here will be a current, and so on. How we can determine the output, if it's voltage or current or time or temperature or frequency, by using the select inputs here. This select inputs is here as a select channel to select which signal to be converted now into digital data, the voltage or current or temperature or frequency or any other inputs. So multiplexer is used to select the required analog input to be converted into digital data. Then we have analog to digital converter to convert this analog signal into digital data. Then this digital data is an input to the CPU, and the CPU will process this data and make numerical and logical analysis and operations. Also, it has another input. The CPU has another input, which is already digital input subsystem. It represents the status of all isolator and circuit breaker of the power system. This input will be 1 or 0, as it's digital. 1 if the circuit breaker is closed, 0 if the circuit breaker is open. So according to the status of the isolator and circuit breakers, and according to the digital data, which is a representation of the data of the power system, the central processing unit will make an action, and send what is called a trip circuit, a trip signal, or a trip command. According to the trip command, we have a digital output subsystem which determines there is a fault or abnormal condition or not, and then interrupt the circuit in case of abnormal condition. So that's all about the complete typical architecture of the numerical relay. Thank you and see you in the next videos.